Yun. So, what's up, Team Bear, no? Sa BTP community and to all our subscribers and in our YouTube channel, no? Pati na rin sa internal team, no? So, shout out to everyone na makakanood na itong market update natin as well as market analysis natin, no? on what's happening with the market right now after NVIDIA earnings. So, let's dive in na, no, on NVIDIA earnings, on what happened with NVIDIA. So, yesterday, NVIDIA gapped up by around 7%, no, at the open. Then, what happened was, okay naman in the morning session, okay naman yung nangyari. But, end of day, nagkaroon din ng, around 5% din to, 5% sell-off from peak to trough. 3% sell-off, no, from peak to trough, no, from the peak up to the, hindi naman trough, but the established swing low, no. So, this is the 15-minute time frame of NVIDIA. So, right now, pre-market session, looking good naman, NVIDIA. Actually, parang opening higher slightly. Actually, right now, negative 0.55% siya. So, today is May 24, 2024. And it's a nice Friday, no? End of week na. And it's around 8:06 p.m. Philippine time. So, medyo volatile yung movement ni NVIDIA right now, no? So, I'm expecting na medyo... Hopefully, hindi naman magkaroon ng follow-through selling yung NVIDIA, no? Like a gap fill. But actually, yesterday, I prepared na rin. I sold half of my NVIDIA. Actually, yung binili ko kahapon na 7 shares... I already sold it and right now I'm protecting my break even. No, so halos lahat ng sell orders ko with Microsoft and Nvidia nasa break even stops ko na eh. So 420, ang weird lang ng average price ko with Microsoft, nag-iba lang. So 424 siya yesterday. I don't know what's happening with my position on Microsoft, but supposed to be my break even point was at 424. I sold half my position, around 41 shares din. And ayun, right now, I'm almost cash. I'm around 86.73% cash. And ang main goal ko right now is to just stay on the sidelines and wait for the real market reaction of post-NVIDIA earnings. So kahapon, medyo siya lang yung nag-gain yesterday. So let's look at what happened yesterday. So all over the board, NVIDIA is the only one that was a good gainer yesterday, no? With significant volume, with significant movement, dahil na rin dun sa NVIDIA earnings reaction or market reaction to NVIDIA's earnings. So AMD yesterday down, negative 3%, SMCI negative 3% as well. All over the board, halos lahat, kahit yung energy and utilities natin, are down except VST, no, one of the main leaders in the utility space. Siya lang yung only up in the utility sector yesterday. So, ayun, medyo I'm expecting a possible follow-through selling or follow-through sell-off in the SPY dahil kitang-kita naman natin on the S&P 500 that this is a big bearish candle, big bearish engulfing candle. Yung ginain ng S&P 500 for around 6 days, kinain niya lang in just one day with a big with a significant volume spike. And looking at the daily time frame, RSI is breaking below the RSI moving average. And kahit na yung RSI moving average mo is still pointing upward, medyo big deal na nag-break below RSI MA yung S&P 500 natin, yung SPY natin. So this is a leading signal actually for a possible retracement move or a pullback move, no, for this index. So I'm expecting a possible retracement at the 50-day SMA at around 520, 518. So actually I want to put up my volume profile para lang makita natin na saan yung mga point of control natin and high volume nodes. So possible next high volume node is at 520. So this can act as a possible support level. So parang papatak or parang babangga na yung previous all-time high. Possible ang mangyari diyan, most possibly mag-retrace, i-test to, tong area na yan, yung 520, yung MA20 mo, yung 20-day SMA line natin, which is the green line, may act as support level. And in confluence with the volume profile of this trading range, itong swing na yan, and the previous resistance level, no, the previous resistance zone will now act as support. So yan yung short-term support. If we break below that level, the 520 level, next level is at 515, 514. So looking at the big picture, S&P 500 at all-time high or just near all-time high, and we are still on an early stage markup. So this is our accumulation base. So parang ito yung big cup and handle natin, and the main target is initially is at 550 and then the 600 level. So the 1618 extension, the reverse fib 1618 extension is at 550. Yan yung initial measured target, and then the 200% level is at 600. So papatap na doon sa round number area na yun. So for the SPX, that's 60K. 6K pala, sorry. So 6K. Nasa katawan. So 6K is the next round number target, no, for the S&P 500. So that's the bull case. That's the bull case for the S&P 500. Bear case, maybe if hindi mag-hold talaga itong 514, the MA100 will most possibly the next support level, no, will act as support level. But looking at the big picture, parang tignan natin to, no, if maging maging bull trap to, medyo bad sign yun. Medyo bad sign na mag-bull trap tayo dyan. Dahil lang yun nga, meron din tayong same levels of high in RSI, and the higher high in price is considered as an RSI bearish divergence. So an RSI bearish divergence type P with your RSI at the same level with your price doing a higher high, that's a big signal na we can experience a possible big reversal, no? Or I mean a deeper reversal structure, no? That's a possibility. Maybe we can distribute at this level. Hindi natin alam. Pwede mag-inverted. Hindi natin talaga alam, no? But medyo low probability scenario yun for me. By the looks of the current market events, no? And looking at the earnings of hindi man all but most of S&P 500 companies and most hot sectors, okay naman yung earnings growth nila, no? And that is a good sign na okay naman yung economy and whatnot. And that can trigger bullishness in the market. So, okay, so bakit nga ba nag-decline yung S&P 500 din? So, one of the key factors din actually, no, aside from profit-taking, syempre, coming from this April 2024 low at 490 for 500 level, profit-taking area na rin to eh. Profit-taking area na rin to since we are at around 6 to 7% from this trough or this low level or swing low level. So, this is actually profit-taking level na rin, no? Actually. So, aside from profit-taking, medyo may mga macro news din tayo na experience. So, let's look at what happened with the macro, no? And, yan, ito. Sa, ano natin, sa trading calendar natin. Trading economics calendar natin. So, we can see that yesterday, what is mga nag-triggered ng sell-off was the FOMC minutes, and they indicated na there is a possibility for rate hikes. There is a possibility for rate hikes if hindi ma-tame talaga yung inflation, no? So isa yun sa mga key factors din. So looking at the CME watch tool, for the first time, no, after many months, nagkaroon tayo ng 1% probability, aggregated meeting probabilities na nasa 550 to 575 basis points. So that's a new thing, no? So rate hikes is becoming a possibility right now in the markets. Hopefully hindi naman, no? Hopefully hindi naman mangyayari yun. But that is a trigger for uncertainty. That is a trigger for the algos, for some institutions to decrease their holdings and to de-risk, no, in their portfolios. So looking at the trading calendar or economic calendar, we can see that yesterday, initial jobless claims printed 215,000 jobless claims, no? 220,000 yung consensus. So there is a decline in the initial jobless claims. So that is a hawkish data. Ibig sabihin, there is a strengthening in the labor market. We don't know tong 5,000 jobs na yan is hindi lang ba na-declare or whatever, but 215,000 versus the consensus, medyo ano yun. Difference of with the expectations. So actually, unemployment rate na nireport weeks ago, we are at around 3.9%, tama ba? So 3.9%. So there is an increase in unemployment, and supposed to be dapat expected na initial jobless claims should be higher than consensus. But what happened was 215,000 lumabas, lower than expected. So that is hawkish data. Global composite PMI flash printed at 54.4, 51.1 yung consensus. So there is a sign of expansion, no? In terms of the manufacturing PMI and the services PMI. So below 50, contractionary. Above 50, that is expansionary. And what happens with expansionary data is that is hawkish, no? For the Fed, that is hawkish kasi that can trigger re-inflation, and mas nagiging ano sila, confident sila na there will be a possibility na bababa yung unemployment, lalakas yung labor market, etc. etc. Tataas yung personal income, and pwede sila mag-increase ng interest rates or just keep interest rates at the same level, no? So 54.4 composite PMI flash. So that is a hawkish data. New home sales yesterday printed lower than expected. So actually, di naman super significant, but ayun, itong composite PMI flash and initial jobless claims, yung isa sa mga pinaka-nag-trigger sa market, no, to sell off din. As well as itong increase in probability or having that possibility or probability for a rate hike. So, ayun. We can also see that the US 10-year yields spiked yesterday. So, breaking above the high of this inside bar candle. So, this is our inside bar candle. Kahapon, nag-breakout siya. Around 1.5% yung increase ng US 10-year yields natin. So, basically, if yields go higher, that is bad for equities kasi that tightens financial conditions. Siyempre, you have higher yields, money can flow or might flow towards bonds. Siyempre, no, higher yields attract some money to bonds. So ayun, higher yields bad for equities, lower ang pinaka-ideal scenario for us, no, as equities traders. So that's yes, 10-year yields. So, spiked higher yesterday, and that triggered the sell-off. Same thing with the DXY. So, actually, we're still inside this inside bar. No, we're still inside this inside bar candle. So, what we don't want to see is a break above 105.2 at this level. So, a break above MA20, this 20-day SMA line, itong green line na yan. If the dollar breaks above 20-day SMA line, that's gonna be bearish for equities. So bearish for equities, bullish for equities, no? If we move lower. So hopefully, mag-act as resistance tong 20-day SMA line. And for the both of our macro index or macro benchmarks. So that's the DXY and US 10-year. So ayun, even the Qs sold off yesterday. No? Bearish engulfing candle, and yun, same thing, we're expecting a pullback toward the 450 level. 450, pwedeng mag-overshoot to toward 440 level. So ito yung overshoot level natin at 440. So parang tutumbukin niya yung 20-day SMA line, tutumbukin niya yung green line natin. So that's the cues. Looking at the small caps, so hindi niya rin na-hold di na rin na-hold tong, ano, tong 20-day SMA line, tong green line natin. So, big engulfing candle then, big red candle yesterday with a significant volume spike. So, 1.34 relative volume. So, that's a significant movement, no, for IWM. So, that signals us that there are more sellers in the small cap space. So, right now, stay away from small caps muna. Kaya rin ako napabenta kay Iren and my other holdings. So, MBY as well. So, big red candle. Big red candle breaking below ME20 and breaking below the value area high of this trading range. So, from this breakout candle, breakout of the all-time high candle, and this trading range, established trading range, ang point of control natin is at 530. Our value area high is at 540. Supposed to be dapat mag-act to a support eh, itong value area high, which is at 540, but hindi niya na-hold, as well as itong MA20 line natin. So, bearish movements, no, nakikita natin in our mid-caps and small-caps. No. So, actually, that's a signal na, yun nga, since interest rate sensitive itong mid-caps and small-caps, talagang de-risking muna yung institutions natin with mid-caps and small-caps. So, let's look at CAF. CLF, this is a much better gauge, no, for the small cap since it takes consider of small cap names na may free cash flow, may significant free cash flow. So 100 names na small cap siya and may significant cash flow, no. So actually yesterday sold off din, nag-sell off din tong CAF natin. Yesterday. Even breaking below this parang support trend line, no? So, break below, close below this support trend line. So, bearish talaga, no, in general yung small caps. So, versus the four nga, no? Parang na-discuss ko na rin na I'm leaning toward the large caps and mega caps. And maybe just underweight on mid caps and small caps. Pag may setup ako nakita. So that's my current views in the market with our main indices. Let's look at our market breadth or market internals, no. So nag-hit yung oversold level, I mean overbought level at 68-70 level. Right now reversing papuntang 50. I mean nag-break below 50% level na rin to, no. So that's a sign na to go cash muna, no, to go cash in the markets. So actually 3 to 5 days ago it was signaling us na magkakaroon ng incoming sell off na rin in the markets. So right now ang bullish trigger ko for based on MMTW. So MMTW is the percent of stocks above the 20-day average. Isa to sa mga green light red light signals ko. If MMTW is at the overbought level, maybe medyo defensive ako during this period. If right now nakikita ko is a big decline, a high volatility move, breaking below 50% level, I'm gonna look for buy on dip opportunities, no. And once it retakes or retests the oversold level at 20 to 30 level, so dito sa levels na yan, yun, baka maghanap na ako ng ano, ng entry points. So every time na nai-hit or nag-establish ang swing low and swing highs tong MMTW, it serves as a leading signal, no, on market downturns or market inflection or bounces, no. So that's our current market internals. Let's look at our market swing monitor. Tignan natin yung naging market action based from a bottom up perspective. So this takes consider of all small caps and above, and kinukuha niya yung mga data na yan. Nineneto niya yung mga data na yan. So May 23 yesterday, 3.2k net advance decline. So that's a big acceleration in selling. So, in the broader market, we can see that malakas yung selling na na-experience natin. No? So, actually, isa din ako sa mga, isa sa mga sellers yesterday. So, net volume spikes, negative 837 din. So, So coming from this negative 200, negative 124, a big acceleration in net volume spikes was experienced yesterday. So mas madaming names na nag-produce ng volume spike and ended at a decline. So intraday momentum, there are more names down more than 5% yesterday than the quantity of names up more than 5% yesterday. So new 20-day high low data, more names breaking below their 20-day low. So for the first time after 10 days, we experience a red print in the net 20-day new high low data. So that signals us na breakouts are not working right now and breakdowns are working right now. So if you are a short seller in the market, you can take advantage of short selling some names. No? Pwedeng inverse ETFs, so mitrade mo, just buy the SQQQ or mga short ETFs or inverse ETFs na mga sectors na trip mo or industry groups na trip mo. Pwede rin names, no? So looking at 52-week high-low data, same thing, negative print. 50-day new high-low data, new high, new low data, same thing, negative print. Halos lahat negative, no? So that shows us na from a top-down perspective, looking at the index, looking at the mid-cap index and small-cap index, even the market internals, MMTW, we can see that there is a broader market sell-off. No? So broad market sell-off yung experience natin yesterday. You can also see it in the heat map. No? Very evident, very evident. So there is a strong signal na just de-risk mo na or just go on a risk-off mode. Risk-off mode talaga muna. So ayan, I still have Microsoft, I still have Nvidia. Onting shares na lang naman. Maybe I'll just use it as anchor positions to trade around the momentum setups na makikita ko or swing setups na makikita ko in both names. So right now, actually gusto ko sana maghanap ng post earnings PED place, post earnings announcement gift place, but looks like dapat ano muna, no? Chillax muna tayo. So yesterday I sold most of my possessions and actually I gained around 5.6k all in all this trading week. So 5.6k around 300k yun, 300k. So thankfully naman gumana naman yung mga swing setups natin and we grinded nicely this trading week. So ayun, maybe a look for some place muna dito. Just do a quick scan. Punta tayo sa Play Finder sheet natin. Play Finder sheet. Then I'm gonna clear this. Copy paste. Medyo mabagal lang yung net. So ito yung mga names na nag-produce ng earnings recently. Actually ito, gapping up 7% pre-market. So apparel and footwear name. Yung Ross Stores. So maybe on the second day, third day, pwede akong maghanap ng entry point. Also, release its earnings, itong SVM. So, silver-related name to most likely. So, double beat din. Maganda yung earnings na, 42M. Something to watch din. Good technical structure. Mukhang nag-create ng bull trap, but right now, maybe invalidated. No? Invalidated bull trap siya. So, that's a nice setup to look at. No? So, PAGS, maybe I'll just look at the top 10. Post earnings announcement display. So also doing a gap up by around 8.5%. I'll wait for a possible entry point. But right now, chill muna talaga. Staying on the sidelines since medyo mas malakas yung selling pressure, no, in a broader perspective, in a broader market perspective. So BORR na recent earnings yesterday. Okay, so revenue beat lang siya, EPS beat, not hindi niya nagawa. Okay, so AM, na-release yung earnings na, nag-gap up, maganda yung reaction. Right now, opening higher, no? Than the candle close or the close of yesterday's session. So let's look at the lower time frame. So this is the extended trading hours. So medyo ano din naman, medyo choppy. Choppy din. So nothing to look at muna dito sa BOR. Also, BORR is considered as a small cap. So 1 billion, 3 billion market cap. So tama ba? Small cap yun. 300 million market cap up to 1 billion or 3 billion yata is small cap. No, tama. So that's BORR. BJ. Okay, BJ. Maganda yung ano niya. Yung earnings niya. Double beat, although super late lang. But I think this is already an established name. An established specialty store name. So big picture, parang all-time high din to, BJ. No? So sa mga mahilig dyan, mukhang pwede to. Mukhang pwede to for me. So lagay natin siya sa ano, sa mga watchlist natin, sa stock list natin. So this is a possible second day play. Maybe I'll look at this play later, no? So it's already 8:30, na-release namin yung durable goods orders data, durable goods orders. So higher than the consensus. So month on month for the month of April, consensus is -0.8, but higher yung lumabas. So another hawkish data, guys, another hawkish data. Ex-transportation higher din than expected, 0.4. 0.1 lang, 0.1 lang dapat yung in-expect ng market right now. So previous month, 0.8, medyo contractionary versus the previous month's durable goods orders. Ito, medyo expansionary din. 0.4 versus the previous month's 0.2%. So looks like the higher for longer narrative is here to stay. Yun, sa yun, napindot natin ito. So sa mga hindi pa nakapag-open ng OKX, kindly look at the description section below. Nandun yung OKX ano natin, affiliate link. So may free ano kayo dyan, may free something. Pwede ko kayo bigyan ng giveaway, no, kung mag-register kayo sa link. So may mga binigay si OKX na caps and jackets, pati na rin t-shirt, no? So pwede ko kayong bigyan once na makita kong nag-register kayo sa OKX affiliate link. Yun, at the same time, mas cheaper yung fees, no? Anyway, post tayo ulit sa US since this is our main market. So looking at the pre-market session, I'm up by around $117 in Nvidia and Microsoft. So I'm at a negative in Microsoft. Weird talaga, 430 average price mo nag-iba. Actually, hindi ko alam bakit. So, titignan ko mamaya sa ano natin, sa ledger natin. So, this is my ledger. Hindi ko na muna bubuksan lahat, but sige, silipin natin. No? So, karamihan ng trades ko came from ito. So, Iren, I gained around 2.4K. Most of my losses, halos super minimal lang, $200. Halos less than 0.2 VAR pa yun eh. Less than 0.2 VAR pa siya sa ano ko, sa portfolio ko. So, MOD, $900. Microsoft as well, $1,000. NU, -500. So, medyo, ano to, 0.25% loss in a portfolio basis. Itong NU, 0.25%. So Nvidia 883, NVT 700, TOS -25. So super minimal lang halos lahat ng losses natin. We are always protecting our break even and we're focusing on strong names, we're focusing on good fundamental names, good technical names na may significant push from the institutions, and we're focusing on short-term plays muna, no, since the market is kind of choppy. So yun yung focus natin post-earnings announcement. Gift plays right now is the name of the game. Also IPO plays. IPO Place. This is my, actually my bread and butter right now, IPO Place. So karamihan ng place ko came from this screener. So this is an automated screener. If gusto niyo ng copy nito, exclusive lang ito sa community natin eh. But maybe I'll do a workaround on maybe subscription or access, limited access on this screener. So mga different place yan eh, mga pullback at 50 day, trend continuation. So automatic na siya. Kinakopy paste mo na lang to, itong watchlist ticker. And then, you can individually look at the names. No? So copy paste mo lang, nandiyan na lahat. Nandiyan na lahat, no? And kung gusto mo ng ano, ng mas malupit na screening way or way of screening, just use your TradingView screener, yung Stocks 2.0. Toggle mo yung watchlist, ilagay mo yung Playfinder watchlist mo, and toggle it to your chart view, chart view. Ibahin mo, gawin mong candles, gawin mong 3-month, and then makikita mo na. No, makikita mo na maayos. So, Eli Lilly, doing good. So, 4-hour time frame chart yan, pag 3-month mo. 3 months, 6 months, I think, the daily candle to eh. Daily candle yung 6 months. So, double check natin. So, hindi na muna. Sige, hindi na muna. Magtatagal tayo. But, overall, this is how I screen, this is how I look for place, and this is how I trade. So, kahapon, nagdagdag tayo kay NVIDIA. So, nag-materialize naman actually yung setup natin. Nag-materialize yung NVIDIA setup natin. So, just to do a recap, if hindi mo pa napapanood yung session yesterday, yung ginawa kong video yesterday, you can rewatch it. But overall, kahapon, I saw this inside bar structure, diba? On the 30-minute time frame. So, after the earnings was released, ganda ng market reaction, rally agad. At the pre-market session, create ng mini consolidation, I bought the 1018 area or 1018 price point. Then my stops was at 990. Then binenta ko din at around 1044, 1045. So the break below the KC10, I mean MA10, itong black line, a break below MA10, I sold my possession or my yung mga shares na binili ko at 1018. So very quickie trade lang siya. So I used my anchor possession at around ano ba yon? I bought it at 913. So na-move yung average price ko to 1019. So if Nvidia moves higher, kunyari mag-break out to 1060, I'll look for another momentum setup on the lower time frame and I'm gonna trade it. So anchor point, using this anchors, no, to trade the markets. So Nvidia, if para sa akin, looking at the pre-market session, looks good naman yung ginagawa ng Nvidia. So bottom line, so just to cap off or to wrap up this trading set, I mean this learning, hindi man learning session, but this video or recorded video, this live stream as well. So nila live stream ko to right now in my YouTube channel, although unlisted. So to wrap it up, ang ayaw nating makita is a follow-through sell-off in the S&P 500. So, if today we experience a follow-through sell-off, talagang stay on the sidelines muna if you're a long-only trader. If you're a short seller, then good. Pwede mo i-trade yung S-triple-Q. But right now, we're opening slightly higher than the close, 520. If mag-create tayo ng inside bar structure at this area, much better if above MA10. At around 5:30. If we close above 5:30, that's good. Maybe you can look for another set. You can look for potential place, no? Should we move higher, no? Or re-break above this 5:30 market high. So that's our views in the market. So the title of our video is broad market sell-off, or the broad market sold off on Nvidia earnings, and ayun nga, yung return of possible returns. So I hope na na-educate ko kayo kahit papaano. Medyo kinakapos lang tayo ng hininga. Medyo hinihika tayo. So ayun, good luck sa lahat. So on Monday, walang trading on Monday, no, in the US market. Memorial Day, so happy Memorial Day to all of our US market traders and sa mga US citizens na watch manonood natin, no. Sa mga mag-anak natin in US, no. Mga tito-tita natin diyan. Happy Memorial Day. So, ayun, that ends my video. Good luck, God bless, and good night. Happy weekend. Bye-bye.